Hey guys, Lucas here and welcome at kNews.space. This time with a capital K because we're back at it again in KSP. Not yet, but soon. As you probably know, SpaceX is about to test their Starhopper and their goal is to hop 150 meters up, move to the side and land on a second concrete platform. The reason for this is probably to check if all the systems work as expected before they can scale it up on the real deal. The final starship will not have to do the same maneuver on Earth, but may be on the moon like the Apollo lander, which also hovered to the side, looking for a better landing spot. Thinking about it, I asked myself, could this be possible using the new robotics parts in KSP? In the beginning I thought, what you get are some robotics parts and a controller for them. Nice, but not really necessary if you want to just launch rockets. So I started experimenting by blocking the engine thrust with sticking some expendable objects into the exhaust. It worked, but was very hard to control. However, as it turns out, the neat yellow controller that comes with it also works on all the other parts, including engines. How this works in Kerbal Essence is you give the controller an input like pressing a button. Then it plays back a certain graph that you can tweak in game, and this graph represents an output value with which you can, for example, control an engine's thrust. Pretty cool. We're sadly not yet able to control the engine's vectoring, but I'm pretty sure it would be easy to mod or maybe even add as a feature by Squad themselves. All they had to do is to add some sliders that track an engine's vectoring rotation on two individual axes. But since that's not available, what I instead use are four more engines firing to the sides to control the hopper's orientation. And this is how the finished graph looks in game. It may be a little overwhelming to see all at once, but really think of it individually. Here, for example, you can see the thrust goes up and down, and you'll be able to follow that in the clip now. I started off checking the engines one by one, which is just, well, just for the looks. Now watch the thrust of the main engine rush through the nozzle, shooting Starhopper around about 150 meters straight up into the sky. Once it reaches its highest point, it will be pushed to the side using one of the yaw engines. The one on the opposite side counters the rotation to not flip. But wait a second, this is of course not how real rockets are controlled because it lacks an important part called the feedback. Starhopper as is has no idea of what's happening to it, it just follows a script. So in reality what you do is to create a so-called feedback loop that can change the parameters of the graph or more precisely the function on the fly. My function on the other hand is static. It can't change itself, so if I wanted to give it some kind of feedback, I had to do it manually. But I'm as a human am of course way too slow, so what I did instead was to repeat the whole maneuver over and over, tweaking the graph to match whatever was supposed to happen. It's kind of a feedback loop, but more iteratively. But now let's watch the final part of this short hop. The rocket comes down again, reorients itself and... totally intended, two-leg landing, of course. The last part of this short sequence is a fake depressurization of the tanks for crew safety. As if Kerbals had safety in their vocabulary. And that's pretty much all I wanted to show and, of course, remind you of the real hop attempt later today. The Everyday Astronaut and Lab Padre host live events on site and SpaceX will stream some more camera angles as well. I will share this craft file I used here in the info box and maybe you'll be able to tweak and land that thing on the VAB. If you prove it in a video, I'll definitely pin it in the comments. Okay, as always a big thank you to all my supporters and I hope to see you in the next one if you like. Auf Wiedersehen and thank you for watching.